that God is a rewarder of those who seek Him diligently. Now, if you're joining us by TV or by radio, this is Dera Beach Revival. God is moving powerfully here. And I want to let this message clear to every one of you that is listening to me, that God will never let you go through what you cannot handle. The Bible says that the Lord shall cause your enemies who rise up against you to be defeated before you. Your face. Now your face, this is in front of your eyes. God will display the enemy's humiliation in front of your eyes before you. You're going to witness that in front of your eyes as your enemies are defeated. But God defeated them already. Someone say amen. All the devils in hell, God defeated them already. Did you hear me? Jesus defeated Satan 2,000 years ago. But you got to realize that Satan has no right to torment you or your family. He has no right over your finances. He has no right over your health. So God says He'll cause him to be defeated before your face. What is the condition to meet this criteria? It's simple and clear. You have to walk in obedience to the faith that comes by hearing the word of God. Your life is a believer. Your life is born again. You are a child of God. And because you're a child of God, you have the right to believe and to walk in faith. For without faith, it is impossible to please God. Without faith, it is impossible to please God. You cannot please God unless you walk in faith. So when you hear the word of God, you must act on it. When you act on it, it will release results in your life. I'm going to show you two things here. God says He will defeat the enemy in your face before you. He will smite him before you. So expect to see the humiliation of your enemy Satan in front of your face when God fights for you. Somebody say hallelujah. You're going to recover what the devil stole from you, because God's word is not man's word. A man could change his mind tomorrow. A man is limited by circumstances. A man may want to marry you now and change their mind tomorrow when they see somebody else. Did you hear me? People's opinions change. Today you could be their dream and tomorrow you're their nightmare. But God has no circumstantial hindrance or limitation on him. He's able to establish his intent without any obstacle. So Satan wants to lie to you that God does not want to heal you, because the devil is a liar. Now watch this. God says he will cause him to be defeated before your face. And God says in verse 7, it says in the continuation, that the enemy shall come out against you in one way. He shall come out against you one way, but flee in seven ways. Some translation says seven directions. Now watch this. Seven ways, and number seven means perfection. The number seven stands for perfection. Once you hear seven, it's around the clock, perfection. So every day of your life, every minute of your life, God has prepared victory for you. Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday, Sunday. Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday. Every day of your life, seven ways. So every time the enemy comes to attack you, God has already defeated him before your face. And God shall cause him to flee before you in seven directions. If there is somebody bewitching you, Somebody attacking your marriage. Somebody attacking your finances. Somebody attacking your future. Maybe you're scared. You're going to lose your house. You're going to lose your job. You're scared you're going to lose something. I got some news for you. If they cannot shut the sun and stop it from shining, how can they stop the blessing of God from manifesting in your life? They cannot stop the sun from shining, and they cannot stop the moon from shining. Because God said, let there be light, and light was. So the moon and the sun are shining. So the sun in the day and the moon in the night. Now watch this. Those two created units are always beaming light. Now watch this. So if their power cannot stop the sun from shining or the moon, how can their power stop God from blessing you? The Bible says, as long as the earth remains, there shall be seed time and harvest. Are you living on planet earth? There is a time to sow and there is a time to reap. Are you ready? This is the time for you to reap your miracle, your blessing. Hallelujah. Someone say amen. You've been sowing your life in worship, in adoration, in raising up your children in a godly way. You've been giving to God. You've been loving God. You've been serving God. God is going to cause you to receive a harvest. I know you are not perfect. Nobody's perfect. But the love of God will manifest in your life. And no devil will stop it. Because the devil is a liar. 2 minutes. 2 minutes. Take your limitations off God. There is nothing too difficult for God. Cancer cannot silence the power of God. HIV cannot stop the power of God. One of the women I prayed for that got healed from HIV, she was here Friday and Saturday and she came with a baby. Wow, she has a baby and married and she's happy. God healed her, took the virus out, she's married and she has a baby. That's the power of God. Somebody say hallelujah. I don't care what your problem is. The name of Jesus is above your problem. I don't care if it's foreclosure. Get ready for 5 homes. Are you facing foreclosure? You will have a home in Dera Beach. Have a home in Boyton. Have a home in Port St. Lucie. Have a home in Orlando. Somebody say hallelujah. And have one in Gonaive. Semak. Somebody say hallelujah. Scream, I believe in miracles. And I believe in God. How many interviews have you failed? Maybe you failed 5 interviews. I got some news for you. You're going to get a job that is better than all the interviews you failed. Somebody say hallelujah. Maybe 10 people proposed to you and they left you there. I got some news for you. God is going to send a blessing that surpasses all the rejections. How dare you tell me that, devil, you a liar. Someone said, devil, you a liar. God is not a liar. Devil, you a liar. The Bible says these blessings, these blessings, these blessings, these blessings shall pursue you and overtake overtake you. The Bible never said one blessing. These blessings shall pursue you and overtake you. Are you aware that there's some things you're about to run into that God gave you already? You thought they're behind? No, they're ahead of you. Keep on walking. Hallelujah. Just keep on moving forward. Hallelujah. Just keep on moving forward. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. The Bible says this blessing shall pursue you and overtake you forward while you're moving forward.